Madam Chair, dear colleagues, many thanks. I would like first to congratulate the rapporteur for the very completed and very rich resolution as well, the relevant report. And I would like to address four main areas that may stay in our agenda. At first, the women's rights promotion, that it's a condition for the quality of democracy, and our fight against women's violence. Women's violence is still a drama in our societies, in our countries, and we must put this issue in our agenda in order to avoid the daily deaths of women in all our countries. The second area that we must address is still the question of the defense of the child's abuse, sexual abuse, and also the problems that they live on the territories where there are armed conflicts. And our convention, the rights of the children convention, must be respected on a daily basis, as well as they must be respected all the children rights on this convention. At third, a third area, the area of the asylum seekers, we have now noticed by the United Nations High Commissioner that more than 70 million of refugees and displaced persons are all over the world, and we must answer to these huge numbers with huge answers, and that it's also that must be in our agenda in order to respect the asylum seekers' rights, to respect the Geneva Convention and the principle of use cogens, the principle of non-refoulement, as also the principles that are inscribed concerning refugees on the Declaration of Human Rights and on the Convention of Human Rights, and also the four issues that the rapporteur approaches also, that is the abolition of death penalty. It's a cruel and human treatment that we cannot have in our OSCE countries, and we must fight against this death penalty that is still present in some of our OSCE countries. At last, a main issue also in the report, which is the education referred on paragraph 66, the importance of global education and education for human rights. Only at school we can change mentalities. Only at school we can build a culture of tolerance, of non-discrimination, and of peace, in order to avoid hate speeches, in order to avoid the populism and the xenophobia that we are seeing also in Europe. The respect for human rights begins always at school, and education is always the key for change. Our parliaments, national parliaments, must be involved and play an active role on this process. Measures such youth parliament programs as national strategies for education concerning equality and human rights are very important. Hearing the voice of students is a very important measure of OCDE that we must also reply.
Amador.
So, for finish,
please,
all of these measures, because we may never know the results of our action, but if you do nothing, there will be no results. Mahatma Gandhi. So it's still a very important way of acting, always in action.
Thank you. The floor now goes.